Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers, my sisters, the Eid has been declared in most countries across the globe. And mashallah, it was cited even in Zimbabwe by so many people in South Africa, in Saudi Arabia, in many, many places. Here in London, it has been announced by those who follow the moons from various places and so on. And I know I'm doing Eid tomorrow. I do respect those who are not going to do the Eid if they didn't see the moon, etc. So I just want everyone to know that Eid is a happy day. It's a very happy day. You have the right to be happy because the month of Ramadan has come to an end. And today is the end of Ramadan where we should be happy that Allah's given us an opportunity. Allah's given us an opportunity to worship Him, to participate in fasting, to refine ourselves, to polish our character and conduct, to achieve piety, to achieve the God consciousness. Let's be from those who don't lose the values that we gained during the beautiful month of Ramadan. So Eid is indeed a lovely, lovely day. I'm so excited that inshallah this year, majority of the people will be having Eid together. It's our dream to have everyone with each other for the Eid. But I just want to draw your attention to something very interesting. From an evidence perspective, from a jurisprudence perspective, there is obviously scope for difference of opinion. Many of us are so passionate about our views that we actually don't mind creating hatred by mowing down the views of others. And this is where I think we fail as an ummah. If they do have a scope, think about it. If they do have evidence, if they do have scope from a jurisprudence perspective to prove what they're saying. For example, there is an opinion that states that the different horizons should see their own moon, which is fair. There is nothing to say that that opinion is totally redundant. There are top scholars from the very beginning who hold that view, so it's okay. And then there are some who say, no, that if the east sees the moon, the west has to also, declare the Eid and so on. That is also a valid opinion. So we need to know this. It's a day of happiness and joy. If a member of your family is not celebrating Eid tomorrow because they did not see the moon, or they're following an opinion some valid opinion regarding the Eid and the moon, etc. Don't spread hate and don't become so passionate that we start fighting, arguing, debating. There is no point in doing that, alhamdulillah. I want to share with you some of my small experiences regarding fasting in the UK. Subhanallah. Not only is it so long, well, alhamdulillah, it's not so difficult. Actually, what's more difficult than the long fast is the time management of the sleep, especially for those who have to go to work or to school or colleges. But it's 21 hours according to the shortest timing. My brothers and sisters, what's interesting is there is not only a debate about the Eid in Northern England and in England, actually. And I'm quite sure in other countries as well. But rather, there is a debate about the time of the opening and closing of the fast every single day. So there are those who started fasting at midnight, those who started fasting at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 3:30, etc. Approximate. So I was asked, what's your opinion? I don't come from this part of the world. Let the ulama who have studied these various opinions for years and decades put forth their little evidences and present it. But alhamdulillah, I want to tell you there is scope for all the different opinions in most cases. And I've come across some of my colleagues who are so passionate about their opinions that they actually remove people from the fold of Islam just because they follow a different evidence, a piece of evidence that might not be the one these people are following, etc. Come on, come on, come on. Let's become people who are mature. The books of fiqh, the books of jurisprudence were written by people who barely interacted with those of other schools of thought. And we have forgotten this. We haven't thought about it. It's the first time in history within the last few hundred years and 100 years, I'd like to think, that people of all schools of thoughts are found in one mosque, and not just in one place, but across the globe. So by default, in a mosque, you'll find Hanafis, Shafi'is, Malikis, Hanbalis, Salafis, people all in one mosque. And you know what? If we're going to start saying, brother, Salah is not acceptable the way you're doing it, what I want you to think about is, if there is a hadith to prove what that brother is saying, in essence, you're saying, well, I don't believe the Prophet was right. Imagine if the Prophet, peace be upon him, came here today and he led Salah in a specific way. Would half the mosque actually walk out because it wasn't their way? That is ridiculous. If there is a hadith to prove that point, look, you need to understand, that's okay. It's a valid opinion. It's jurisprudence. Come on. You need to grow up. You need to mature. You need to understand those books of fiqh that you are following. At times, they have not taken into consideration the fact that there will be people of all schools of thoughts reading salah in one masjid. Sometimes there are four imams alternating Taraweeh, each one of them belongs to a different school of thought, but they have evidence, they have, you know, people have gone back and already invented the wheel. Let's not go back and reinvent it by creating discord once again. So remember, if you're going to say my salah is not done when I do it this way, you know, one of the things that irritate me is regarding Salatul Witr. When witr is read in a specific way and people actually walk out, and there is a hadith to prove that, subhanallah, if the Prophet ﷺ came and led it that way, would we walk out? And it is a hadith. It might not be my school of thought, but trust me, if the imam is reading it that way, you say Bismillah and you read it because it is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So this is something that I dispute even the scholars regarding. My colleagues, I actually tell them, look guys, I believe you're making a big mistake because you're challenging the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. That's what we're doing. So it's a beautiful day, and I'd like to speak about this because even the last year I spoke about the Eid, and I did say that, look, the moon, you can have Eid today, you can have Eid tomorrow, you can have Eid the third day, or you don't have to have it the third day, but don't fight. And I know people started saying, what are you saying? I'm speaking from knowledge. I know what I'm talking about. I'm telling you, I might have worded it simply, but evidence perspective, it is correct. What I've said, there is scope for the difference of opinion. So respect it and grow up, mature. That's what you need to do. You need to grow up, because if you don't grow up, trust me, you're going to create a disaster amongst the less knowledgeable of the ummah because of you and because of the way you're looking at things. So my brothers and sisters, we need to become much more mature regarding the opinions we hold. And yes, you follow what you believe is right. I promise you, because on the day of Qiyamah, you're going to be asked what you believed was right. But remember something, someone else might be convinced with something totally different. They will be asked about what they were convinced with. So let's not become so passionate that we develop this hate and we start losing the whole purpose of the entire ummah and the beauty of it. So mashallah, tabarakallah, I'm in London. I've just heard the declaration of Eid, mashallah, the moon sighting. I think there are still a few groups that will be seeing the moon here in London. I'm quite sure it will be quite visible here by the will of Allah, if Allah wills. But I'm quite sure from a human perspective, it would be perhaps possible to view it here. I'm not from this part of the world, so I actually don't know all of the politics that happens here. But I do know that there is a lot of hatred when it comes to Eid. Come on, guys. When it comes to the start of the fast, we've got a problem. When it comes to the end of the fast, we've got a problem. When it comes to Taraweeh, we've got a problem. When it comes to Eid, we've got a problem. When it comes to everything, we've got a problem. I think we need to mature. I think we need to realize and understand unity is not about uniformity. Unity is not when we all do the same thing. We all eat pizzas, so we're united. Come on, grow up. That's not what it's all about. We've all eaten food. That's what it is. Some might have pizzas, some might have burgers, some might not even want fast foods. We would love to have slow foods, mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. I love you all for the sake of Allah. Trust me, even if you differ with me, so what? Subhanallah. I will continue with my opinion. I respect the other opinions that have evidence to prove themselves and they do have a scope within Islam. I will respect it and I will disagree with it at the same time. And I will not decrease the love that I have for you, because do you know what? We're all following the Prophet ﷺ and what he has said. Sometimes what I believe is absolutely correct or more correct, you might believe that that is not more correct. You might believe another piece of evidence is more correct and more valid. We may discuss it. We may come up with a common view, perhaps some of us, and we may not. We may not come up with something common. You might still be convinced after the discussion that what you have said is actually much more valid than what I have said. So that's amazing and beautiful. Brother, sister, I still love you. Trust me, if you don't do Eid tomorrow and you really have not seen the moon and you're following a proper opinion, no love lost. I respect you I might not do it the way you've done it, but subhanallah, the fact that there is scope for it, alhamdulillah. I have some of my colleagues who are mature as well. Mature, when I say mature, they are mature from a difference of opinion perspective. They know how to manage difference of opinion. Not someone who spits venom from the mouth the minute someone disagrees with them. No. I've spent a lot of time studying evidences of those whom I disagree with. And that's made me a very tolerant person, because I've realized if this is a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, even though it might not be as as strong as I would have liked it to be, or it might not be my opinion, it might not be something I consider the most correct, etc. It might not be within the specific school of thought and so on. I still am very, very scared to create such damage and harm against something that is evidenced in the life of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Like I say, I remember one of my colleagues saying, you're not allowed to read witr this way. And I said, hang on, there's a hadith. Imagine if the Prophet ﷺ came here and he actually read the witr that way, because there is a hadith, there is evidence to prove this. So you might not have seen it. It doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. You know, you might believe this or that. It doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It does exist. Stop confusing the masses. You need to understand, you're here, they're doing it this way, do it this way. At least you've practiced upon that hadith a few times, or one time, or whatever many times in your life, and you do know that, look, Ya Allah, this was a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, and I was in the masjid where they did it this way, so I did it that way, rather than stepping back and going back, following those who've never interacted with people of other schools of thought. Remember this. And that's why when I look at books of a long time back, mashallah, we learn from them. They were our scholars, we respect them. But there's one thing they didn't have, and that's what we have now. They didn't have such a large number of masjids with people who follow all schools of thought in the same mosque. I mean, you go anywhere in the world, it's so cosmopolitanized that you'll find people of all walks of life, all schools of thought, all races, many nationalities, all in one masjid. And here you have people pushing their one opinion and saying the rest of them are not, their salah is not done, it's not accepted. Hey, calm down. Salah belongs to Allah, not to you or me. You do what you believe is the best and the most correct, and let others do the same in their way. And this is how we will be able to achieve the best of unity. And this is how we'll be able to achieve unity through diversity. We are diverse, but we're united, we're strong. You know why? We've respected each other's opinions. We all ate, but I didn't eat what you ate. But we ate, and we're all full, mashallah. We've all thanked Allah, and we're all energized to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is something we lack in the ummah today. That's my Eid message for all of you, my brothers and sisters. And I pray that we can benefit from this beautiful message. I'd like to benefit myself, and I want to encourage my colleagues and the others who are perhaps leaders of the ummah to steer the ummah through learning to respect people who have difference of opinion within the scope of and the frame of the sharia, not necessarily your piece of evidence. They may be following another piece of evidence. It may not be as strong as your evidence according to you, but according to them, it might be the other way around. So let it be, let it be. My brothers and sisters, let's mature when it comes to issues facing the ummah, because we're actually splitting ourselves in such a bad way that one day when we're mowed, it's going to just be wholesale, and we don't want that to happen. It's our duty to speak up and to at least learn to respect each other. Jazakum Allah khair. Eid Mubarak to one and all. That brings me to one other point. Saying Eid Mubarak, you can say Eid Mubarak, you can say Kullu Amin wa Antum Bi Khair, you can say, for example, Taqabbal Allah Minna wa Minkum, but don't forget the Islamic greeting still remains, Assalamu Alaikum. Don't miss that out on the day of Eid or the Friday. So before you say your Jum'ah Mubarak, at least say Assalamu Alaikum, because that is the greeting of Allah, the greeting of Jannah, the greeting of the Quran, and the greeting of Islam. So Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullah is what you start with, and after that you can say your highs and your hellos and your good mornings and good afternoons and whatever have you, including your Eid Mubaraks and Jum'ah Mubaraks and Shadi Mubaraks and etc., etc., etc. May Allah bless every one of us. I hope you've spent a moment listening to me. I don't want to take more than the time I've already taken. Guys, start preparing for Eid. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. By the way, P.S. See you at the Valentine's Park in Ilford, inshallah. If Allah gives us the life to be there, the opportunity, and inshallah the health, we will see you there in London tomorrow by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.